Well, this is the video y'all been waiting for, the brand new back steps. They've been done about a month now and I'm very pleased how they turned out, even though I ran into a few problems when installing and building them. The entire project took me about a week. I did the entire project myself. The only thing I needed help on was figuring out the rise and run of the stairs, which my neighbor helped me out with. I could have got the job done sooner, but we had crappy weather to deal with during that week I built the stairs. And I'll get a close-up. And the entire stairs, including the post and rails, were constructed using pressure-treated lumber. The old sets of stairs were built using untreated lumber, and it was rotting every 5 years, even when painted. It was quite a pain. Every 5 years, I'd have to replace a couple stair boards or maybe fix the rails. It was a real pain in the ass. But these new sets of stairs, they're built better than the old set, and they should last a long time. The stringers were constructed using 2x12 pressure treated stock, laid out with a framing square and cut with a circular saw, with a 7-inch rise and an 11-inch run. And there's three stringers. There's one on this side, one on the other side, and one in the center. And there's five steps. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all the way to the bottom. And on each stair, there's 2 2x6 boards with a 1/4-inch gap for drainage. And in between each couple of stairs, there's a 1x8 piece of pine right here, 3/4-inch, that's covering up the center because I was afraid that if somebody walked up the stairs, they might accidentally kick that center stringer, which could be kind of dangerous. So that way I covered up that center part right here in between those two stairs. And the post were constructed using 4x4 pressure treated lumber, and I had to notch them to fit around the stringers. Let's wait for this plane to go over. They're a pain lately. Anyways, I had to notch the 4x4 post to fit around the stringers, and I had to bolt them using half-inch carriage bolts, galvanized, two of them. There's two on each side. And from the tread of the stair all the way up to the cut, the miter, it's 34.5 inches, plus the 1.5-inch 2x4 handrail equals 36 inches. 36 inches is the normal for most railing height. So 34.5 from here to here, and plus 1.5 inches 2x4 handrail equals 36 inches. One of the problems I ran into was where the notch fits around the stringer right here. The post was crooked. It was like this. And I had to put some washers in between the stringer and the post notch to correct that problem. Now the post is level. I mean, it ain't perfect, but it's good enough. Nothing's perfect. Before I shimmed it, it was like this. After I shimmed it with those washers, it was like that. So it's more better now. It ain't totally perfect, but it's all right. And before I screwed the stair boards on each stair, I laid them out to check the overhangs. Some overhangs at 1/4 inch, some at 1/2 inch. And that's what second and third step means. These boards I had to trim on the table saw. So all the overhangs were matching, because some overhangs at 1/4 inch, some at 1/2 inch. And the ones that were 1/2 inch, I had to trim the boards down with the table saw. And that's what second step and third step means. And another problem I ran into was this ledger board right here. It was warped in the center. And I had to adjust the stringer so all the stringers were equal from end to end. From end to end. I had to eyeball them like that. But otherwise, the project turned out great. I'm very pleased with it. I think it was my first major project that I actually did. I worked my way up from the smaller stuff all the way to the bigger stuff.